بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brother Hajji coming to you on his channel. The Shi'a have been quite deceptive and quite clever when it comes to discussing or having a dialogue regarding the noble companions Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma. When it comes to cursing generally, we know that they don't have a favorable view of the companions anyway. So they'll say, oh well, we don't do it in front of your face, but yeah, it's part of our tradition. By you, even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises them, that's a different topic altogether. But what we'll do now is when it comes to Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma, they won't be quite straightforward when it comes to these two noble companions. And the reality is they don't want the Sunnis to know what they really believe. They don't want the Sunnis to know, especially when it comes to Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma, because they know that the average Sunni, even though that they're not very practicing, they know about Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma, and they know how dear Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma to Ahle Sunnah. So they're not going to be so bold and mention their narrations, which I'm going to do, by the way. As you know, this is a series, so you're going to see that this is a view textually within Rawafidhism, which if you have any honor, you're going to come out and say, we believe it. This is our belief regarding Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma. Our narrations, which are authentic, we have this opinion regarding these two, and we don't want to say what they are, because the narrations are going to do it for me. But you need to be straightforward. You can't be playing this taqiyya game. This taqiyya game and this charade that you've been playing for so long, you try to pin everything on the Shirazis, that's not going to happen no more. Because you hold the same belief. Stop playing. Stop being deceptive. This is your belief. You don't disagree with them. It's just you're not so straightforward. You're not so brazen to do it. And this series is ongoing. There's going to be many episodes. And when you combine all these narrations together, you're going to have no choice but to say, yeah, we do accept them. There is so many narrations textually from your infallible imam that have said the worst things about Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma. Now let's present a narration from the Shia, which we're going to present many, but this shows you what category they have placed Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma in. And then what we're going to do is, when this series is over, we're going to say, okay, these are your narrations regarding Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma. What about this? So is it possible that Ali radiallahu anhu accepted this from them when he called them this? Let's see what Ali radiallahu anhu said about Abu Bakr and Umar in one of your narrations. This is Taqrib al-Ma'arif, okay? Now let's go to this narration, okay? In Taqrib al-Ma'arif, under page 238, okay? And you can see the narration, it's on screen, okay? You can see the narration, that's on screen. That he said, alayhi salam, in his famous khutbah, after Ba'da Qatal al-Uthman, Ba'da Qatal al-Uthman, and he said, and indeed Allah has killed the tyrants in their best condition and gave safety to those who used to be oppressed. Okay? And listen to this. Subhanallah, this is where it gets really, really disturbing. وَمَاتَ هَامَان وَحَلَكَ فِرْعَوْن وَقَتَلَ أُثْمَان. So he says, astaghfirullah al-azim, this is allegedly what Ali radiallahu anhu said, and made Haman to die and destroyed the Pharaoh. And he killed Uthman. Indeed, now your situation has returned to the state of the day that Allah sent his prophet. According to the Shia, how they categorize Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma, they've categorized Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma in the same category as Fir'aun Haman. So he presented the khutbah of Ali radiallahu anhuma. So let's see what he says regarding this khutbah. He said, so he, alayhi salam, called the first one Haman and the second one Fir'aun. Always you'll notice a pattern as the series goes on. They won't specifically mention the name. At times they will and at times they won't. They either say the first, the second, the third, and also code nicknames. This is how deceptive this cult is. They won't specifically say it. At certain times, in certain narrations, they won't specifically mention the name. And then he says, listen to this. Because there was no need for him to practice taqiyya in his case. due to the fact that the listeners shared his view in taunting Uthman, and he described the state of the people to the state of the day that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam was sent. And this is explicit about their deviation. You see? So basically what they're saying is, Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma are categorized in the same level as Fir'aun and Haman, who are the biggest tawaghit that the earth has ever witnessed. That's the level of hatred they have for Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma. Now let's carry on. Then Ali radiallahu anhu said, allegedly, so he's quoting a narration from Ali radiallahu anhu. He said, indeed, the ones who had no share in this matter of Khilafah preceded me in it. And the ones to whom he had been granted to, and for them, listen to this, subhanallah al-azim, وَمَنْ لَيْسَ لَهُ مِنْهُ تَوْبَةً إِلَّا بِالنَّبِيِّ يُبْعَثُ. And there is no forgiveness except through a prophet that comes anew. Look at that. So those who preceded Ali radiallahu anhu in the Khilafah, meaning Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma, and Uthman, if you want to include him in that, but more specifically they mentioned Abu Bakr and Umar are on the same level as Fir'aun and Haman. Okay? And indeed, there is no prophet as to be after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. And there is no other person closer to the brink of the fire than such a person. So will they fall by it in the fire of how? Okay? So Abu Bakr, Umar radiallahu anhuma, and Uthman are destined for Jahannam. So he said explicitly that those who preceded him in Khilafah had no right and had no permission from one who has the right to Khilafah, and said that those who did it cannot be forgiven except through a new prophet. So he closed the door of forgiveness for them by putting a condition that cannot be fulfilled. Meaning that Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma are destined for Jahannam. And then, let it carry on. And it did not suffice to that. He rather continued that they were the closest to the brink of the fire. And he did not stop there until he said, what did he say? فَأَنْحَارَ بِهِ فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمْ. Okay? He said, so they will fall with it, by it, meaning their lies, in the fire of hell. So here you go. Now to make matters worse, okay, for the Shia, to prove that this is something that's substantiated, they're trying to play, you know, the taqiyya card. But it's not working, mate. You know, we've got the narrations ready. It's just to put it on video. And we've already done many episodes. It's just releasing it whenever. Now, as you can see, we got Bihar al-Anwar, okay? Bihar al-Anwar. And this is narration is also in the Rawda of Al-Kafi. Okay, and this narration is authentic, so you could check it. Okay, this is authentic. I'll give you the chain of narrators now. Okay, the chain of narrators as follows. As you can see from the screenshot, it's the narration is very lengthy, but I'm just going to get to the main point. Okay, that the chain of narrators are Ali bin Ibrahim bin Hashim al-Qummi, and Ibrahim bin Hashim al-Qummi, and Hassan bin Mahbub al-Sarad, and Ali bin Rahab, Yaqub al-Sarraj. Okay, there's a chain of narrators for you. It's very lengthy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has killed the tyrants in their best conditions and gave safety to those who used to be oppressed. The same in Taqribul Ma'arif. Now look what Majli says at the end, or Majusi. He says, قَوْلُهُ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ وَأَمَاتَ هَامَانْ أي رَمْعَ. You see the code names that they use? رَمْعَ. وَأَحْلَكَ فِرْعَوْنَ. So, you know, so you see, the narrations are quite clear-cut that Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma and Uthman included have been labeled and categorized with the worst of creation. It's an authentic narration that Bakr al-Majusi quoted. It's authentic. And obviously, in Taqribul Ma'arif, it's also quoted, and the scholar in question, or the Dajjal in question, Taqiyyaddin Abi Saleh Al-Halabi, comments on this and explains that, look, this is what alayhi salatu wasalam said, that they're going to be burning in hell and they're the Pharaoh. How is it possible for an infallible imam, a ma'soom imam like Ali radiallahu anhu, to pledge to someone who's similar in rank to the biggest taghut on or who walked the face of the earth, meaning Fir'aun? How can he have done it for Islam when the individual that he gave his bay'ah to was the worst of creation? Because Fir'aun was the worst of creation. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, according to you, is an equivalent of Fir'aun. So he saved Islam by pledging to a Fir'aun-like individual. Does that make any sense? How could he have done it for Islam when the individuals who gave bay'at weren't even a Muslim in the first place? And I'm going to carry on. There's many more episodes to show you what else you've said about Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma. So if you don't know about this, this is a musiba. If you didn't know about this. And if you do know about this, then the game's over. So rest assured, you do know about this. I believe you do know about this. So now you've got to come out openly now. And every time we ask you about Abu Bakr and Umar, this is what? Just a taster. This is just a taster. So I'm telling you now, you've got nowhere to hide no more. Okay, you got nowhere to hide no more. So we're going to now press you on this. You hold Yazid and Muawiyah to be evil individuals. But in light of the narrations that are going to come out, Abu Bakr and Umar, in comparison to Yazid and Muawiyah, this is a different level altogether. I don't think we should be even talking about Muawiyah and Yazid now. That we're going to show you what else you've said about them. So what we want now from you now is come out openly and be brave and say, this is what we believe about Abu Bakr Umar. And this is what? Just a taster. I'm just saying, come out. If you're brave, if you got nothing to hide, just come out. When you do your next video, just say, yeah, Brother Hajji is right. We believe in this narration. And we believe Fir'aun. We believe Abu Bakr is Fir'aun. We believe this. So what? This is our belief. We're Shia. We're Shia Ali. And what? Come on. Let's see if you do it. Because you ain't got the cojones, man. You don't have it in you. You ain't got the bottle. You don't have it in you. Simple. I'm badgering you right now. Come on, prove me wrong. I guarantee you, mark my words, you ain't got it. You don't have it in you. You guys are like your 12th Imam, which is the Dajjal, that ran to save his life, and now he's hiding for nearly 1200 years. Because in your own books, he said, the reason why he went into Ghaiba was because he was scared of getting killed. So, Alhamdulillah, Ya Ahle Sunnah, wake up. Don't fall for their traps. I've got many more lined up. You guys met him knowing that he spews sectarian rhetoric. How he accuses Aisha radiallahu anha of allegedly murdering the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you guys know what he says about the companions. You know what he says about Ahle Sunnah wal Jama'ah, what he says about us. Yet you went and met him? So your ideology is not far apart. It's just you're against how he promotes it. You're against how he spews his rhetoric. But in essence, you agree with it. Because you agree with what he says. You see him as an authority. So stop your games. You've been exposed enough. Stop acting like you're innocent. You guys hold the same filthy creed as him.
One of the most popular Shia figures who directly inspires terrorism is Yasser al-Habib. Yasser shot to fame due to his hateful preaching, mainly on his channel Fedak TV. This channel is known to preach a hateful message which is considered extremely insulting to Sunnis worldwide.
أي أحد تجده قبل بأن يسمى أمير المؤمنين فإنه منكوح. فعلى هذا عمر بن الخطاب مثلا الذي تسمى بهذا الاسم ورضي به كان لا ريب منكوح. ثم من بعده عثمان بن عفان ثم معاوية.
Most worryingly, Yasser is known to have links to militant groups in Iraq. Here, you can see him taking part in a procession in London with a group that he founded. Notice the blue flags? This is Khuddam al-Mahdi, a registered UK charity. Here they are again, this time in Iraq. Again, the same blue flags. Here, at a Khuddam al-Mahdi event in Iraq, you can see the names of the revered Sunni figures of Abu Bakr, Umar, and Aisha written on the floor for people to walk and spit on. And here, you have an Iraqi soldier, posing proudly with Yasser al-Habib's book, a compilation of slanderous claims about Aisha, the wife of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, designed for one thing, and one thing alone, to incite hate. ما هم بأمة أحمد لا والذي فطر السماء ما هم بأمة خير خلق الله بعد أن وانتهى ما هم بأمة أحمد لا والذي فطر السماء ما هم بأمة خير خلق الله بعد أن وانتهى ما هم بأمة أحمد لا والذي فطر السماء ما هم بأمة خير خلق الله بعد أن وانتهى ما هم
الوهابي إن لم تقتله فدرك والوهابي يجب أن لا تضع قدماه الذي تأرض العراق الطاهرة لا مكان له في العراق أما المساجد التي يحكمها ما يسمى بهيئة علماء المسلمين وهي هيئة علماء الكفر والفساد والمنافقين فهذه المساجد يجب أن تهدم ولا يجب أن يتم التراجع عن هذه المسألة. قوانين الله يجب أن تطبق بدون محاباة وبكل صراحة وبدون مراعاة لأحد.
كانت الرسالة واضحة تقول بأن النصر للرافضة قدر، وأن المعركة الحاسمة آتية، وأن شيعة الكرار عليه السلام لا يخافون أوقع الموت عليهم أم وقعوا على الموت. من جانبهم أطلع الضباط العسكريون الشيخ الولائي على آخر المستجدات في الجبهات والقواطع القتالية وعن دور القوات في حماية وتأمين المدن المقدسة، مؤكدين بأن جميع عناصر اللواء هم طوع أمر قيادة خدام المهدي عليه السلام، وأن قلة التمويل والإمكانات لن تمنع من مواصلة ضرب الجهاد والتضحية حتى النصر إن شاء الله. جدير بالذكر بأن الشيخ الحبيب كان قد دعا قبل سنوات إلى إحياء شرطة الخميس كقوة ردع وتدخل سريع.
Iraqi militias are regularly found proudly waving the flag of Khodam al-Mahdi. Here, in this video filmed in Iraq, a representative of Khodam al-Mahdi is preaching sectarian hatred to rouse a Shia militia before they storm a Sunni village. This was filmed on Yasser al-Habib's Fedak TV.
I was going to say, a lot of stuff going on, lots of politics. Again, you know, Bayt al-Qadir, what is going on with Bayt al-Qadir, man?
ما هم بأمة أحمد لا والذي فطر السماء ما هم بأمة خير خلق الله بادئا وانتهاء ما هم بأمة
All scholars.
Which scholars do you follow?
Sheikh Saduq, Sheikh Mufid, Sheikh Tabrisi.
How about the scholars of today? Do you take from any of them? Just so I know which...
Yes, I follow Sayyid Sani in terms of my fiqh masail.
You've got nothing to do with Yasser Habib.
That's a deviant sect within Shia Islam, and I don't follow him.
Okay.
Yes. In regards to Muawiyah, we believe he's a munafiq.
You're saying to me that your wife would not be the closest person to you?
Not necessarily.
When the Prophet says the best among you is the one who's the best to his wife.
How about this? From the Quran, I'll prove to you Aisha was a liar, you prove to me she wasn't.
Alright, so until then, subscribe on my channel, bro. Hajji wa salla ala nabiyyina Muhammad.
وشيطان يحاصرني أبا كم مرة قد أظلم الدرب ضحى وتحدر الدمع وضاقت بي